So a class 10th, today we're going to start with the chapter Madam Rides the Bus. And this is a very sweet chapter. Why? Because it's the story of an 8-year-old girl and she has never traveled by bus and never traveled alone. And it's about her journey, how she the planning, right? She wants to ride the bus and all the preparations that she makes, how she saves the money for it and how she decides the time to go and her journey on the bus, right? The ride that she takes. So it's not right, it's a long journey, but it is just one point to the other and then she comes back because she just wants to see where does this bus go every day. Where do the people come back from every day? So every day she sees people going and she sees people coming and she wonders where is it that they go. Okay. Have you ever traveled alone? Has anyone of you traveled alone? Yeah? Anyone? Have you traveled alone? By bus, or by train, by public transport? Have you? No? Okay. You have not. Right? Suppose in case if you have to alone, what do you think are the things that you need to keep in mind while traveling? What are the things you would have to keep in mind? Yes, actually you'll have to see your seat, where you're going to be there. You'll also notice the passengers who are with you. Alert about the station where or the destination where you have to get down. And right, so the instructions we get, we need to take care of our luggage. You have to wear a mask. Of course, that is there, obviously. And you have to take proper precaution. You have to be careful while traveling. And you get so many instructions that don't talk to strangers and don't accept any eatables from others. You know, getting all these instructions that you get. Right? So, so later on, sometime in life, you will be traveling alone, and then as you go, you will be taking all these necessary questions. So, this is where you have to be alert about that. You have to be careful about, okay, which is my station where I have to get down. If you're traveling by train, you need to be sure that even by bus and even if you're catching a flight, you have to be careful that you reach on time, okay? Because, you don't want to miss the train or the bus or your flight. Fine? Yes. Now this story, it's Madam the Bus. An 8-year-old girl, she keeps on looking at people coming and they go every morning, they travel by bus. And she's very curious that what do these people do? Where do they go? What are the things that they see? And an 8-year-old child traveling alone on the bus. This is what this story is about. It's a very cute story. And even though she's a little girl, where does this madam come? Right? Who calls her madam? And does she behave like a madam? Right? So madam is not necessarily a teacher. Right? Okay. So you call. Yes, out of respect, the lady is here, right? So when you address them with respect, that is madam. Okay, so how does this little girl, who calls her madam? What are the things she notices as she travels on the bus? And yes, we know that life has a good side, it has a bad side. And in a small journey, a small ride on the bus teaches her lessons. That the way she was laughing on the bus, about the things that she sees, and she's so happy, and this is what she wanted. And then she notices the things that makes her sad, that makes her happy. Right? But first of all, yes, we need to admire the courage of this little girl. And once again, she was a very brave, courageous girl. This is the story in real life. Please don't pack your bags and go riding a bus without informing your parents. Never ever do that. We need to be cautious. We need to be careful. And yes, here, naturally, without informing our parents and without informing our family members, don't go out anywhere. In this sensitive story, an 8-year-old girl's first bus world outside her village is also her induction into the mystery of life and death. So it's the first time she has stepped out of her village, first time she's gone on the bus, and yes, she goes on the bus, she is introduced or she is inducted, welcomed into this world, which has a lot of problems, which has a lot of joys, which has sorrow and happiness side by side. So she learns so many things, right? So in just one day, so many things about life she learns. She sees the gap between our knowing that there is death and our understanding. So we do know that, yes, death is inevitable. We are born, we're going to die. When and how? We don't know. But when you see such things happening, then you realize that, see, it is a part of it. You understand it. Right, so these are the things that we are going to read in this story. Now, yes, so we will find, maybe as it is here, when you are traveling on a bus, these things that you would find, a set of passengers, you get off the bus, tickets please, conductor asking, a row of seats, blowing a whistle, the conductor blows the whistle, get on the bus, platform, right? Then a roar and a rattle as the bus it starts here and slowing down. So the bus, how it gains its speed and then it slows down. All these things would be discussed in the, right? Now you must have traveled by a bus more than once. So if not by bus, you've traveled by road. Now what can you see from a fast moving bus? Given below are some suggestions. What are the things? Do you see rivers? Do you see roadside shops? Fields, hills, railway tracks, vehicles, all these things we talk about. And you can, right, you've noticed all these things when you travel by groups. So if you have not traveled alone, then definitely with your parents and all these things you see around you. Okay? Now let's start the story. So can we start reading? Yes, we can. There was a girl named Vali Ammai, was called Vali for short. She was 8 years old and very curious about things. Her favorite pastime was standing in the front doorway of her house, watching what was happening in the street outside. There were no playmates of her own age on the street, and this was about all she had to do. So is this story about? It's about Vali Ammai, or for short, we call her what? Vali, right? And yes, on the street where she lived, there were no children of her age, and she didn't have anybody to play with. So what was the thing that she did? She would stand in the doorway of her house and she would look at what was happening. Aate jaate logon ko dekhna and all, that is what the things that she would notice. Okay? Is this clear here? Yes. So who's the little girl in the story? Vali Ammai or Vali? How old is she? She is 8 years old. Okay. Right. Yes. Right. So she is 8 years old. And what does she do? Right. What is the thing that she likes doing? That is just standing in the doorway and looking at the street. So, and sometimes, you know what? Yeah. So when you don't have anything to do, or just like that, when you sit in the balcony of your house and you look at people coming and going on the street, at times it's also a pastime activity, isn't it? You can spend time doing that also, right? Observing people, where are they going, who's coming back, and what is happening in the street. So, right? Yeah, so there are days when you actually sit outside and do nothing and just watch people coming and going. But Vali, as a young girl, because she did not have children of her age to play with, right? So she was there in the street, only a small child, no one of her age. So what would she do? She would stand in the doorway and she would look at people coming and going. Okay? So Willie, standing at the front door, was every bit as enjoyable as any of the elaborate games other children play. She did not get bored. And she did not, you know, like, of course, what is this? I don't have anyone to play with. But she found it as interesting as the games that children played on the streets, right there. So with their friends. But she never got bored and she loved just standing over there and watching people coming and going. Watching the street gave her many new, unusual experiences. So she learned a lot just by standing over there and looking at the people passing by. The most fascinating thing of all was the bus that traveled between her village and the nearest town. It passed through her street each hour, once going to the town and once coming back. The sight of the bus filled each time with a new set of passengers was a source of unending joy for Bali. So she would stand in the doorway, but what was the thing that interested the most? That was a bus leaving from the village. It would go to the nearest town, then it would come back again, right? So when it would go, it would have one set of passengers. When it would come back, it would have another set of passengers, right? So because it would go, stop at the next town, so the people would get down, new passengers coming, and then they would come. So every day this would happen, the bus coming, the going, right? A set of passengers leaving, a different set of passengers coming back, right? So she just loved watching all this. And it was a source of unending joy for Vali. It gave her a lot of happiness. Day after day, she watched the bus and gradually a tiny wish crept into her head and grew there. As she would watch the bus, a chota sa wish, you know, came to her mind and the idea started growing. What was that? She wanted to ride on that bus, even if just once. So she wanted to ride. Now, because she saw the bus coming and going every day, an idea came in her mind. And that idea became a wish, and that wish became very strong. I want to ride on this bus. This wish became stronger and stronger until it was an overwhelming desire. Vali would stare wistfully at the people who got on or off the bus when it stopped at the street corner. Their faces would kindle in her longings, dreams, and hopes. So she would stare wistfully, but, you know, like with that longing, she wanted to go on the bus and would think, hey, wow, how lucky these people are. They're traveling on the bus, and I want to go on the bus, right? And it would kindle in her longings, dreams, and hopes. So kindle means ek ichha, you know, like man mein, you know, that feeling would come. It would set beginning those feelings, right? Start those feelings. Oh, I want to go. And she would, you know, like, yes, it, this feeling became stronger and stronger. If one of her friends happened to ride the bus and try to describe the sights of the town to her, Vali would be too jealous to listen and would shout in English, proud, proud. So if her friends, you know, they traveled by bus and they would come and tell her that, see, Vali, I went over there, I went by bus, this is what I see. She would not listen and she would say, proud, proud. You know why? Because she was jealous. And she wanted to travel on the bus herself. Okay? So she was there very, like, what? Because she would not listen to others because she wanted to ride on the bus herself. Neither she nor her friends really understood the meaning of the word, but they used it often as a slang expression of disapproval. So none of her friends, they really knew the word, proud, proud. They would just say it because they had heard it, right? And they use it as a slang, you know, of expression of disapproval. Things they did not like, they would, you know, say, like, not what the goodness is, it's a proud, and they would not listen to anybody talking about their stories or about their adventure. Okay, are these paragraphs clear? Yes, so let me see, are you actually listening here? Let me just see you all here. Yes, so let's see here now. Who's going to give me the answer? What did Vali like to do? What are the things that Vali like to do? Yes, I can unmute you. You can speak up, give me the answer. Raise your hand, please, if you know the answer. What was it that Vali liked to do? Tell me, please. What did she like to do? Who's going to give me the answer? You can text me, you can raise your hand. I'll unmute you. Speak up, please. What does she like to do? She just like to stand in the doorway and watch the people passing by and the bus passing by. Okay, right. So what was it that Vali really desired to do? What was the thing that Vali desired to do? Yes. What was it that she wanted to do? Yes, so she wanted to ride in the bus. And where did the bus go every day? Where did the bus go every day? To the nearby town, and it would come back, right? So she would watch the bus going and coming, and she would hear people coming down from the bus, the conversation, and she would love to be on that bus, right? And what was her reaction when friends would tell about their experience on the bus? How would she react when somebody would talk about their experiences? Would she listen to them? No, she would not. What would she say? Yes, proud. Okay, you traveled on the bus and you're being proud about it. So she did not like listening to it, because what did she want to do? She wanted to ride on the bus herself. How old is Vali? How old is she? 8 years old. An 8 year old having this desire, she wanted to ride on the bus, she wanted to see how it felt and what are the things that would be there. Okay, is it clear till here? So as I told you all, it's a very simple story, and right, but what is there? Yes, it's about the lessons that we are going to learn. A little child, right, might not be aware of so many things that happen in life, but when you step out into the world, once you step outside your house, you are exposed to so many new experiences, right? And here, when she's going to travel by bus, let's see what are the things that she's going to notice. Let's see what are the things that she's going to learn. Okay? Right. Over many days and months, Vali listened carefully to conversations between her neighbors and people who regularly used the bus. And she also asked a few displeased questions here and there. So she would ask questions here and there. What? That how does it feel, or what are the things that you see on the bus? So she would talk to people, she would listen to these conversations. Yes? Okay, Dhruv Mehta is just asking me, how are you, ma'am? Are you fine? And I am absolutely fine. But where is Dhruv Mehta here in the classroom? So I don't see him. And because Dhruv is such a nice child, I don't expect him to behave like this. Yes, Amrit Pal, you want to say something? What? Please turn on your video and speak. Yes, so what is happening is that over many days and months, Valli listened carefully to conversations between her neighbors and people who regularly use the bus. And she also asked a few discreet questions here and there. So very carefully, she's making all these inquiries. When does the bus leave? Where does it go? Maybe about the money for the ticket and all, right? Who can ride the bus and all that she's asking. This way, she picked up very small details about the bus journey. The town was 6 miles from her village, right? So 6 miles. The fare was 30 paise one way, which is almost nothing at all. She heard one well-dressed man say. So a well-dressed person saying, oh, 30 paise is nothing for the bus ride. But for a little girl, it might be quite a bit. So does she have that much money? How is she going to reach that money? But to Valli, who scarcely saw that much money from 1 month to the next, it seemed a fortune. She didn't have so much of money, right? So she maybe did not get so much of pocket money, so much money to spend on school skill care. That was too much. The trip to the town took 45 minutes. So one side of it is 45 minutes. On reaching town, if she stayed in a seat and paid another 30 paise, she could return home on the same bus. So she's thinking, because it's a bus, it goes and it comes back. So this is what happens. So she thinks that I'll need 30 paise for the town and then 30 paise to come back. So how is she going to collect that money? How is she going to arrange that money? She could return on the same bus. This meant that she could return home on the So, right. So if you have any problem here, just please don't just text me if there's any doubt at all. Okay. Right. So no need to make calls to me. And right. So this way she picked up various small details about the bus journey. The town was 6 miles from her village. What was the fare? It was 30 paise, 30 paise coming and going. So she needed 60 paise. Okay. And how much did it take? It took 45 minutes. On reaching town, if she stayed in a seat and paid another 30 paise, she could return home on the same bus. This means that she could take the 1 o'clock afternoon bus, reach the town at 1:45 and be back home by 2:45. On and on went her thoughts as she calculated and recalculated, planned and replanned.